Live from Media PA, it's News on the Lane. Good morning, I'm Max and M.
And I'm Blake J, reporting from the Rosemary Angelina Broadcast Center.
Today is Wednesday, February 23rd, 2023. It is the day 8 of the 12-day cycle.
Our Pledge of Allegiance will be led by some idiot-laden students. Please stand, face the flag in your classroom, and put your right hand over your heart to recite the pledge.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence.
Please join us in reciting the Bobcat Pledge.
We pledge to be ready, respectful, and responsible, offer a helping hand, be a friend to everyone, care about feelings, accept differences, tell adults they're not for what is right.
Please be seated for some news and announcements. Today, the big story on the lane is that today, our fourth graders participated in the NAACP Black History Month poster contest. This year's theme was Children and Young People of the Civil Rights Movement.
The posters look amazing hanging in the main hallway. Be sure to check them out and learn more about some important people who fought for what was right. Here's Ms. Hatton with an important announcement about the poster contest winners.
Good morning, it's Mrs. Hatton with an important announcement about our Black History Month poster contest. I would like to first congratulate all of the winners. We had our fourth graders participate in this contest, so we had over 50 posters that were submitted, and these are our first, second, and third place winners. First place goes to Elle Wernert with her poster about Ayanna Najuma. Second place goes to Hans Kratz for his poster about Harriet Tubman and her work as a young person. Third place goes to Molly McNiff for her poster about Ruby Bridges. So I'd like to congratulate those winners that will attend an award ceremony hosted by the NAACP on Saturday morning. The honorable mention posters will be recognized by us at school, and these students also had amazing posters. It was a very close contest. We had teachers vote and a committee sort of review all of the criteria for the posters, and these came up as honorable mentions, which is also a high honor. So these go to Marla Ulrich, Jacob Danley, Kaylee Reed, Charlotte Kubica, Vivian Delosier, and Gabby Yingling. All of the posters were amazing. I want to thank all the fourth graders that participated. And if I called your name for any of the awards, if you could stop down at the library sometime today, I do have something for you.
We have some birthdays to announce for this week. Take a look.
Happy birthday, everyone.
Today's main lunch is grilled cheese, tomato soup, steamed green beans, veggie of the day, and your choice of juice or fruit.
The alternate lunch choices are a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, other assorted deli sandwiches, grab and go, or a salad.
We are doing a great job earning Bobcat brags. We now have this many brags.
We'll be right back.
check out our Bobcat who earned a brag yesterday.
Keep up the great work, Bobcats. We'll earn our next school-wide reinforcer and reach our goal of 500 Bobcat brags.
February is Black History Month.
Did you know that Rosa Parks was not the first black person to refuse to give up a seat on the bus?
Rosa Parks was famously credited for sparking the civil rights movement and the Montgomery bus boycott when she refused to give up a seat to a white man in Alabama in 1955.
However, it was Claudette Colvin who was arrested for the failure to give up a seat on the bus several months prior to Rosa Parks. Claudette was only 15 years old at the time.
Orchestra rehearsal is tomorrow morning at 8 a.m.
The Good News Club meets tomorrow after school.
And now, Jake A. is here with today's Believe It or Not fact. Jake, what do you have for us today?
Thanks, Maxton. Today's fact is Australia is wider than the moon.
Wow, Jake, that's amazing. You learn something new every day.
Blake, you can believe it or not.
And now, here's Chloe G. with today's special report. Chloe, what do you have for us today?
Thanks, Maxton. Today's special report is about the Polar Pop. We're raising money for Special Olympics, so please consider participating. Now through March 17th, you can donate through the website and then post a video of you popping a balloon filled with icy water over your head. It's for a great cause. Back to you, Blake.
Thanks, Chloe, for that special report.
For all crew members and special reporters, I'm Max and M.
And I'm Blake J. Have a warm and wonderful Wednesday.